Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Friends, today we have a topic with us that is goodwill. Now, goodwill is a topic, you know, which has an immense level of importance because, I mean, why? The goodwill that is recorded in the books of account is not at all the one that you are expecting, that is the self-generated goodwill. No. The goodwill that is recorded in the books of accounts is the one that is recorded of the takeover base goodwill. So the goodwill that has been acquired with the help of amalgamation, in acquisition of amalgamation. So let me get you down to the nitty-gritties of this particular topic. So first question of mine, what is goodwill? Okay. See, goodwill is basically an asset, you know, but this kind of asset is what? It is intangible in nature, right? And it cannot be seen. So it generally arises from the, as I told you at the very beginning, it arises of the acquisitions of when acquisition of two companies happens, this kind of goodwill arises. So it is the amount that the acquiring, let's say A is the acquiring company, they pay to the target company. Let's say there's B company, which is a target company. For the amount, it is basically the amount that the acquiring company pays to the target in excess of their book value of their assets. So if a company pays less than the book value of the asset of the target company, then it is called as the negative goodwill. This is the difference. Now, simply goodwill, as the name suggests, is a good name of the company. Organization in serving its products or services, they do it over the period of time. Now, because of its services, the value of the firm basically, it exceeds the assets, its assets and intangible goods name in the society towards company or brand or product or service, which is called as, you know, goodwill in accounting term. See, under the accounting terminology of US GAAP or IFRS, it is identified as an intangible asset with an indefinite life. So it is what we call as amortized as the other intangible assets. However, it is periodically checked for improvement. Now let me make you learn how to calculate goodwill in M&A, that is mergers and acquisition. See, we will learn to calculate the goodwill step by step with the help of an example. Now let's assume that, you know, there is company A here that has acquired company B for the total consideration of, let's say, $480 million. Okay, now let's now look at step-by-step process to calculate goodwill in this particular scenario. Step one will start, you know, you need to find the book value of assets. So you can find the book value of the assets from the what we call as a balance sheet. You can find the details from the balance sheet of the company. Let's say the income state, this is the income statement. There is sales has been recorded at 400, expenses 350, and the net is going to be your net income, just a hypothetical one. Okay, now on the other hand, you also have your balance sheet. So your balance sheet will have a couple of things like assets, amount, liability, and amount. Okay, so let's say on this side we have cash, current assets and fixed assets. The amount which is standing is 60 80 100, that amounts to 240. And liability, we have current liability, long-term liability, we have shareholders equity, and we'll write down the amount as 40 20 and 180, which again amounts to 240. So let's work on the step two part. That is, in the step two, we'll find the fair value of assets. Now, the fair value of the assets can be determined with the help of the accounting firm, okay? Because they are well equipped to value these assets of the firm. So I'll give you, you know, how the fair value of company B will be calculated. There will be the fair market value of all the assets of company B here. Let's say there is other current assets that are standing at $100 million. You need to pull this number down. 100. You have fixed assets that is standing at, let's say, $180, and it has FMV, that is the fair market value of liabilities of the same company. Is, let's say, they have their current liabilities and non-current liabilities, that is standing at, let's say, 40 and 40. So this is the step two where we calculate the fair value. Now let's work with step number three, where we calculate the fair value adjustments. Now the fair value adjustment is the difference between the fair value of the asset of company B and the book value of the asset company B. So I'll write that fair value of asset of company B minus the book value of the asset of company B. Okay, so how it's gonna worked out, it's as simple as that, is equal to bracket this 100, right, the current assets, right, less 80 plus 180 fixed other fixed assets minus 100 less bracket 40, that is the current liability, you can see above 40 minus 40, that gives you our final answer as 100. Closely to that, we haven't missed one thing. You have to deduct 40 minus 20, that gives you 80. Now we need to calculate the step four part, that is, you know, calculate excess purchase price. So the excess purchase price is basically the net of actual price consideration and the book value of the target equity. This is going to be our purchase price. So the actual price that has been paid is, let's say, 480 million. The net book value, the NBV, is, let's say, is 100 plus 80, I'm just taking down those numbers, plus 60 minus 20 and minus 40. This is the net book value. So the excess part, the excess purchase part, is the actual purchase price less the net book value, and that's 300. So finally, let's calculate goodwill. Step number five, goodwill, and it is the difference between the excess purchase price and the fair value adjustments. So it's going to be 300, the excess purchase price, minus the fair value, that is 80. So that's going to be 220. So that is actually our goodwill. I hope you have understood how things have been worked out. This example must have given you a complete approach of how to calculate goodwill and what goodwill is all about. Just follow the steps, put your own numbers, take up your own companies. Let's say, you know, take up some M&A based comp from Google and, you know, try and work out on your own company. And let's see how far this concepts are working for you. So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and, you know, liked the video, if you think that, you know, if you have enjoyed and learned watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.